Guys, in this video, I'm going to explain about cell class in C# programming. In other words, we can say that how to stop inheritance in C#. So let's begin. In C# programs, a class is made a cell class to stop its inheritance. Means, if a class is celled, it cannot be inherited or inheritance by subclasses or derived classes. Means if you don't want to make a base class, like if you don't want a base class to be inherited by any other derived class, then just use that class as a celled. So if a class is celled, then it cannot be inherited by subclasses or derived classes. Except extension, a celled class is used as normal class. Means we can create object, we can call methods or defined within the celled class also. But we can't inherit celled class. So celled class doesn't react like a base class. Let's see an example of the celled classes here in C# program. You can see that the class car is a celled class. We can make a class as a celled class by preceding keyword celled before the class. In this class, a constructor is present here, and the another method run is also here. Next class I'm marking here to test the celled class is class final C#. So as we discussed that celled class cannot be inherited. So I'm just trying to inherit celled class car here in this class final C#. So here an error occurred. Here an error occur. When I run this program, the compiler will give an error that final C# class cannot derive from celled type, because the celled class is not inherited by any derived class. So in this way we can't inherit the celled class car here, but we can call the method of the celled class in the main function by creating an object of the class car. So I'm just running here this program. You can see that control first comes inside the main function. Here I am creating an object of the celled class car. The object name is C. And you know that whenever we create an object of the class, the constructor gets called automatically and will execute the statement console.writeline and print celled class colon car on the console output screen. You can see here, next control comes back to the calling point, means within main function, and again call the run method from the object C using dot operator, and run method will print the statement car running on the console output screen. So this is the final output of this program. One important thing to be noted here is that one important point to be note here about celled class is that if we don't make a final class, a celled class in the software project, it will still work. But this is best practice to make a class celled if it is not required to be inherited, or due to some constraint it is not required to be inherited, so it cannot be inherited accidentally. Suppose if a software developer will try to inherit it unknowingly somewhere in the software product, or software project, then compiler will complain and flash an error at compile time. So due to the compiler at the compile time itself, so due to compiler complaint, the programmer will analyze the intention of making the class celled and proceed accordingly. So if you don't want that any that a class can be inherited, so put celled keyword before that class, and this is the best practice for software developer. If he writes some function that are not accessible to other classes, then just make that class as a celled. Thank you. If you like this video, then please share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.